today's video is going to be my Premier League predictions. I know you'd probably want this one, and pretty much every football YouTuber does this, so I'm going to do it as well, bottom to top. And you hopefully are wondering where I'm going to place your team, where I'm going to place all the other teams, where I'm going to place my team, Leicester City, of course. And who am I going to put bottom, who am I going to put top, who knows. But before we get into this, remember to like, subscribe and hit notifications if you want a 75% chance of getting good luck for a week. And even if you don't get that, you're still a legend and part of the Fox River Army. And also, please go and subscribe to Glitch United. That's a channel with me, Football Tricky TV, and Glitch Hypes YT. So remember, subscribe to my channel, Glitch United. And that's pretty much it. Enjoy the bottom of the league. I'm going with Burnley. So, as you see, 20th there, Burnley. Because I just don't think they really have the calibre. They don't have the pace. I mean, Aaron Lennon was their only fast player last year. They've got too many tall players. They're too lanky and not fast enough. Chris Wood, Sam Vogt, Ashley Barnes. It's just not good enough for them. And I think they'll finish rock bottom, 20th, like low amount of points. They'll score from a lot of corners, probably one of the most corner goals. But just they can't score really from open play with those tall players. Not enough pace. Anyway, to the next 19th, I've gone with Brighton, as you see up there. I think they were really lucky to stay up last season, if I'm totally honest. And that's not just me, because I wanted Cardiff to stay up. Please, Brighton fans, don't dislike the video. Yeah, I just don't think they're the Premier League calibre. And I think Cardiff were really good last season. Personally, I think the refs were against them. And all of their chances, they just didn't take them. And as I say, like, Cardiff fans, don't dislike the video. Appreciated. Anyway, with 18th, I put Bournemouth. Now, before all of the comments, like, why have you put Bournemouth 18th? Why are they going to get relegated, in your opinion? Give me a second. They can't finish off their chances, in my opinion. Yes, they beat us 4-2. Yes. No. Stop. Yeah, I just think that the atmosphere in the stadium is just not got enough fans or seats. So, like, usually you think the fans are going to get behind the team, and that's what really brings the players up and helps them move along. And, like, if you're losing, you hear the fans, like, they're all cheering you on most of the time, saying, like, come on, we can do this, and it brings the chances. They think that they have a decent chance on getting this comeback or getting this win or getting more goals. You never know, whatever it is, it just, the fans, imagine football without fans. It would just honestly not be very good. And talking about fans, I'm going to vlog as many Leicester games as I can. That's quick, that's just a disclaimer. I will be vlogging the Scunthorpe pre-season friendly, so that's coming up soon. And I think I'm filming the Cheltenham and Cambridge pre-season friendly, and I should be filming most of the Leicester home games because I have a season ticket. Right, on to number 17. Now, initially, I hadn't thought this to happen. I thought they'd come someplace at 13th, but that was before the news that their manager was going. And I'm pretty sure you've already guessed it. Newcastle United, 17th. They will edge it. I don't think they will get a good manager. I don't know what manager they will get. I just don't think. I think Rafa Benitez was pretty much the only person who could take charge of that club and bring them somewhere. Mike Ashley has put them right down into a hellhole. And he's really upset the fans. He's angered the fans. And now that Rafa Benitez is going, after the fans have been begging him to stay, I think it's just the club will fall down. And maybe they'll get relegated next season unless they get a good manager. And maybe some good signings they need. Almiron was signed in January. He's made a decent impact, but that was their only player. They've not signed anyone yet. And James Justin's came to Leicester. And I'm really happy with that, because James Justin, everyone's been saying class right back. Right mid Ricardo, right back James Justin. I think that should happen. Anyway, on to 16. Might think this is questionable, but with 16, I've gone with West Ham. Now, West Ham, I just don't think they're very good. Because, listen to all the complaints about the fans in the stadium, they want Upton Park back. They played better at Upton Park, in my opinion. And Pellegrini is just not a good manager. Maybe they finished all right last season. Yeah, you can say that in the comments all you like, yeah. But I think they just won't do very well this season. Four nows could make a good impact, but I think he'll be a bit of a flop, if I'm totally honest. He was good in La Liga, but with La Liga, there's only a few really, really good teams. And then there's a lot of very, very bad teams. And then there's pretty much every La Liga 1-2-3 team that comes up to the proper La Liga Santander isn't the best. Like, Huesca came up this last season, Real Valladolid did, and they're just poor teams, if I'm totally honest. Like, I doubt that there'll be any fans from those teams, but, like, as I say, like, don't dislike the video. I try hard. So, honestly, West Ham, I've gone with 16th. Their players just, I thought, Mikel Antonio isn't the best striker anymore. Lanzini's pretty much injured. He barely came back at all. And Lucas Perez, just like, the fans hate him. Like, he was expected too much, to do too much, and, like, they were all expecting him to be an absolute wonder kid, but that's my number 15. I've gone with Southampton. I think they'll do well, and it'll be a bit like a Cardiff team. They'll do well in every game, but they just won't really take their chances. But Hasenhüttl, the Austrian, made a very good impact, and I think Southampton, they won't have the worst season. Their players, like, they are about 15th place finish, and, like, I think Hasenhüttl will pretty much, his tactics and his ability to be a manager, I pretty much never heard of him, and I doubt any of you people watching this had either. But I just think he's came in, he's done really well. They beat Arsenal 3-0, but, like, it can't be that special because we beat them, like, 3-0. Oh, sorry, it was 3-2. But, like, I just beat them 3-0, so it can't be that good. No, I'm joking. Southampton, perfectly good team. Hasenhüttl has took over and done very well. And I bet you've been thinking, what's happening to our old owner? Because about 1 or 2 months ago, Cassini, their old owner, was about to go to Bolton. Feel bad for Bolton because it slipped out of the last second. And they remain in administration, -9 points for the season. But that's my 15th. 14th place will be Sheffield United, in my opinion. And you might be thinking, Sheffield United, rock bottom, straight relegated, not good enough. I disagree with all of that. Lots of people around me have been saying, Sheffield United, bottom of the league, or Sheffield United, relegated. I think they will stay up. And I think they'll do it quite well as well. They've got good atmosphere behind them. In my opinion, they've got some decent players as well. And I really hope they sign some good players, because I like Sheffield United. Yeah, only because I did a FIFA career on them and made them the best team in the world. But off that subject, so I just think they'll be really good. And I think they'll just perform. And they've got some good players. Billy Sharp, starters. And it's just a really good team. John Fleck, Duffy, Norwood, Basham, O'Connell. It's just a really good team, in my opinion. They've got Baldock. And I don't know what they'll do for goalkeepers, because Dean Henderson has gone back to Man United, which won't be good for them anyway. 13th, I'm putting Norwich City. Now, Norwich, perfect season for them, I think it'll be, because some of their fans, I think, must be expecting them to, like, be in a relegation fight. But I really think they'll come in, they'll do well, they'll put up a performance, and I think they'll just absolutely, like, smash what they were expected to do, because they have got some absolutely brilliant players. Like Teemu Pukki, for starters. Teemu Pukki, like, he's scored so many goals. last season in the Championship, and he pretty much came from nowhere. No one had ever heard of him. Norwich fans were like, why have we got this clown in the club? And what did he go and do? Get top scorer by the Championship by far. He was an absolute brilliant signing. Best Championship signing last season, in my opinion. They're just really good. They've just got a brilliant team. They're going to stay up. 12th will be Watford. Now, Watford, another average season for them. In my opinion, they messed up last season near the end. That's just my opinion. Go hating me in the comment section. No, please don't. Like, please. Yeah, I just think they'll be decent, average. They've got the players to stay up. If they don't stay up, it will be a shock, in my opinion. But, like, they've got Pereira, they've got Gray, they've got Deeney. Well, I mean, Deeney and Gray, like, bringing with his first game. And let's not go to that subject. Will be Crystal Palace. Three words, but Crystal Palace fans are saying a lot. Zaha, please stay. Like, he's not staying, I'm sorry. Man U the speculation, he's going. That's just my opinion, but he's going. So, if he isn't going to go, then I think they'll get top half. But, like, he will go. He wants Champions League football. He wants Europe. Well, no, I forgot Man U Champions League football. Okay, yeah. I remember now. Yeah, they came sixth last season. It needs to be better than that. But I think, let's not go to the subject of Man U just yet. But I just don't think Crystal Palace will do well without Zaha. But maybe he won't leave. So you never know. But, oh yes, McArthur in midfield. I'm so excited to see how he's smacking them in top bins. I'm going to lose. It's probably Wolverhampton Wanderers now. Europa League, it won't mess them up completely. But it won't get them Europa League again. Their only chance of getting Europe is if they win Europa League. I can see that one happening. Yeah, and I really hope they just enjoy their holidays in, like, Ukraine, Kazakhstan, and, yeah. It'll be beautiful weather, won't it? Well, Diego Jota, he might leave. Apparently, there's speculation. Got that from somewhere. They've got a lot of good players. Ruben Neves, Moutinho. Vinigre is one coming from the future. Bolly, Bennett. We've got some good players. And, yeah, Jota. I think I remember that time. Let's not go to that subject. Everton. Now, you just can't blame me. Right. Everton, they'll come on. And I know you're thinking, well, Leicester, the Leicester fan bias, that you're just going to make them come high up. Yeah, I think they'll do well. But Everton, Richarlison, top quality. They've also got Bernard. They don't play him. I don't understand when Everton played us and, let's just say, it didn't end well. He absolutely ripped our defence apart. I mean, we did have Puel. That's my fault now. We had Puel. That's, like, my way of saying that it was my fault. But Everton, ninth. I really think they'll just come ninth. Anyway, let's go to eight.
Sometimes, you know, what else can we do when we're feeling low? So take a deep breath and let it go. You shouldn't be drowning on your own. And if you feel you're sinking, I will jump right over into cold, cold water for you. Different places, I will still be patient with you.
Everton. Oh my gosh, don't start saying Leicester won't finish above Chelsea and Arsenal. Because I think they will. That's just my opinion. Chelsea. Now, Sarri's gone. I'm not saying he was a good manager at all. But I don't want them to get Lampard. I'd rather he stayed at Derby. I'm praying for Derby to keep Lampard and keep him in the team. And keep him on the manager, because maybe Derby will get promoted next season. And I'd like them to stay up like Derby, even though they are our rivals when we play them. You could say it's not very nice, but yeah, I just think Chelsea will come seventh. Just now, at the moment, you've all been waiting for. Well, some of you have been waiting for. Sixth place, Leicester City. Right. No. I'm not dealing with that at the moment. Yeah, I know. Before you say, I know I haven't put Aston Villa in there. No. But I think Aston Villa will be absolutely brilliant. So, why not Zoom? Anyway, Leicester, sixth. Leicester are going to be really good this season. Brendan Rodgers is going to boss it. And I even think they've got a chance of making top four. But I'm not going to make that much. Because when I react to these, you never know. I might be going like, I might be crying. And you might see me crying for the first time on camera. But like, I mean, Leicester, sixth. There you go, all right? Okay. Right. Thank you. Fifth place, Aston Villa. Now, you've all been waiting for this. Now, the reason I think they're going to do so well is they're signing some really, 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 really good players. Now, they've signed Wesley. Okay, so for all of you people who don't know who Wesley is and don't really follow the Belgian league, neither do I, but I just know who he is because we played Club Brugge. He plays for Club Brugge. He plays in the Belgian league. He is rapid. He's so fast. And he's just really good. He's got a shot and a half. And I just think Aston Villa will do extremely well. And that's where all of the hate comments start flooding in. Alright, I'll see you when I'm doing fourth place, which is literally in a minute. Fourth is going to be Spurs. Now, Spurs, just, they're good. They're always going to come fourth or third. No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, everyone who's a Spurs fan, but you're not going to win the league for a while. Let's just say that. At least I won't get many insults. But there you go. That's just like, there's nothing really much to say about Spurs. I mean, it's not like they're going to sign anyone. So, like, yeah, so I may as well not talk about them because they're not going to sign anyone. So, Manchester United, now they've signed some really good players. They might sign De Ligt, they've signed Daniel James, they've signed Wan-Bissaka. They've got some really good players in the club now. And I just think they'll come third, get a Champions League spot back. And that's just my opinion, alright? Second place, Man City or Liverpool. Now, if that's what you've already calculated, they're two teams final left. I think Man City will come second. Now, there you go. Liverpool winning the league. I may as well explain it all in this one video. So, Man City, right. They're not gonna want it as much as Liverpool. Liverpool have won a Champions League. They'll want the Champions League now, won't they? Liverpool want the Premier League. So, I think Liverpool want the Premier League more. Man City want the Champions League more. So, Man City are going to do well in the Champions League, but Liverpool are going to do well in the Premier League. And if you want me to do a Europa League and Champions League predictions, please like this video, hit notifications, subscribe, and comment down below UEL/UCL. And if you want me to do a Championship predictions, comment down below Championship predictions, like this video, subscribe, and hit notifications. And that's it. Fox Forever out. Roll the outro.